survey says it's 6 o'clock. Time for Family Feud. Now, here's your host, Grant Denyer.
With us, happy Monday. Welcome to Family Feud, where two families will be battling it out for $10,000 and the chance to win an all-new Mitsubishi Outlander just by guessing the top answers to some easy questions. So let's meet our families. First up, would you please welcome back our champs on their second night, the Buccheri family. Who has a team captain who is so good that they brought two of them.
Hi, Sarah.
Hi.
We are twins, aren't we?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Just checking. Who's the rest of the team?
So, my twin sister Emily, my brother-in-law Daniel, and my fiancé Adrian.
Great to have you guys back and ready to take them on tonight. It's the Murray family!
Hello.
Hi, Christine.
Hi.
Only one of you?
Just one of me, yes.
Well, who are the other three?
Well, this is my husband, Ben, my sister-in-law Emily, and my brother-in-law Rob.
Let's have some fun, shall we? So, team captains, round one, let's play the feud! We surveyed 100 people and the top 7 answers are on the board. Name something that's a lot of trouble to take care of. Christine?
A child.
A child's a lot of trouble. Very close to the top answer, Sarah.
A sick person.
A sick person? Let's see. No. Pass or play, Christine?
We're going to pass.
We're going to pass. Is there a way to tell you guys apart?
Yeah, but...
Other than the gigantic name badges that you're currently wearing.
That's the easiest way. Yeah.
But what are the differences?
She's about a centimetre taller. That's about it.
That's it.
That's it.
Who's the bossy one?
That me. I'm the captain. Yeah.
Self-appointed too.
Yeah.
Of course it is. You ready to play, Emily?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Name something that's a lot of trouble to take care of.
Well, I have a puppy and she is a lot of work. So I would say pets.
Pets.
Animals.
Let's see if it's on the board. Nice!
Hello, Grant.
I am going to guess that you take the longest to get ready out of all of them. Is that right, Daniel?
Possibly. Possibly, yeah.
There's nothing wrong with looking pretty special, is there?
Special when you're on TV, come on.
It's a big chance.
He's our own rock star.
That's
you,
it.
You are the resident rock star and you play very well at this. You ready to get started?
Let's go.
Something that's a lot of trouble to take care of.
yeah, I know what they're thinking, but I'm going to say elderly people.
Let's see. Well played. Name something's a lot of trouble to take care of.
I'm thinking maybe a car.
Let's see car on the board. Yeah. Name something that's a lot of trouble to take care of, Sarah.
Your appearance.
Yeah, yourself.
Yourself, yeah.
First strike. Emily, something that's a lot of trouble to take care of.
Let's see. I'd take care of... think...
Too bad, I'm afraid. Daniel, two strikes down. Now the Murray family could steal, so they're having a think of an option. Unless you can stop them, Daniel, name something that's a lot of trouble to take care of.
I've just recently moved out, so maybe a house.
A house would be... Three strikes, I'm afraid. Murray's, welcome, Rob, what would you say?
I would say lawns, gardens.
Emily?
I kill a lot of these. Indoor plants.
Ben?
I'll go along with plants as well.
She kills a lot? Okay. Yep. Christine?
We're all plant killers. Yes. I am going to go with plants.
For the steal, is it on the board? Oh, no, it's not! The Buccheris get the early points. Remaining answers are... You should be ashamed of yourself, young man.
I was going to say that.
We even had that discussion. Who then just doesn't go there? The answer's on top of your head, not even in it. 72-0 the Murray family right now. Now, if they win for 5 nights, I'll be taking home the amazing old Mitsubishi Outlander. This awesome car seats 5 and is packed with features like Bluetooth phone system, touchscreen audio, reversing camera and 7 airbags. And now here's a question for all of you playing along at home. I want the top answer to this one. Tell me an English word that would be known around the world. We'll come back with the answer after the break. Can't go anywhere. I asked, tell me an English word that would be known around the world. How did you go? Did you play along? The top answer was...
Hola!
Hola! Our families are playing for $10,000 right now. So, Emily and Ben, let's play. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something you find in almost every room at... Emily?
A chair.
You would find a chair. Good job. Ben, would you like the remainder of the question?
Yes, please.
Name something you find in almost every room of the house.
Carpet.
Let's see. Pass or play, Ben?
Play.
We're going to play. I love it when there's conjecture on the family table. Play, pass, play, pass. Half's doing
he was
one.
Louder than me.
Did you come here, Emily, with any particular strategy in mind, or is it just come and have fun?
Well, we have a strategy, but I'm not going to tell you because then the Buccheris might steal it. So.
Just pretend nobody in the whole world is listening right
well,
now.
Well, the strategy was if we had eight answers on the board that we would pass because we thought that we could let them have it and stuff it up and take the steal, but Ben didn't play along.
You didn't get that memo?
No, I didn't get that one.
Lovely harmony so far on the Murray team, everybody. Going well. Name something you find in almost every room of the house.
Windows.
Let's see if it's on the board. And it is. Name something you find in almost every room of the house.
Doors.
Is it on the board? Is the Murray family, Christine?
We're a happy family. Family girls, actually, except for Ben.
And a few ring-ins.
Yeah, two girls and Ben.
Something you find in almost every room of the house.
A TV. TV.
What does the board say? First strike. That's all right, Ben. No need to stress. Something you find in almost every room of the house.
I'm hoping lights are up there.
Bit hard to live without them.
A bit dark.
Let's see. Yeah. How about you, Emily?
I'm going to say walls. You can't really have a room without them.
That's right. Three to go, Rob.
So it'd be remiss of me not to say ceilings then, wouldn't it?
Of course.
Absolutely.
Two strikes.
Sorry, Rob.
Now the Buccheri family could steal, so they're having a think, Christine.
All right, Grant, I have one now.
The board will be the judge of that.
I'm hoping for curtains. Curtains.
Let's see if you're right. No, sorry, Christine. Righto, Buccheris. Adrian.
People.
Daniel.
I'm going to say a roof.
Emily.
Benches.
Sarah. You're the captain. One of those options or your own for the steal.
I had another option. I didn't actually discuss it with them.
Oh, cool. Just spring it on them now.
No, I can't ask them.
This is for your official answer is...
Oh, I don't know whether...
Go rogue. Just do it. That's why you're the team captain.
Can I go by myself?
Yeah. Go for it.
Say mess.
A mess. Name something you find in almost every
toys
room of the house.
Toys and mess. And
you'd find a mess. Yeah?
In my house you would.
Let's see if you're right. For the steal, is mess on the board? No! She went alone and it didn't work. Remaining answers are... Furniture.
Light switch.
Floor is in the house. That's okay. You guys didn't have any of those anyway, did you?
No.
Righto. Next one's for double points, everybody. Having fun? We are. And it's close. Time for double points. Daniel and Emily, let's play. Oh, it's on,
it's
Mark.
On.
Don't
it's
get on. Going. We surveyed 100 people and the top 5 answers are on the board. Name something that's small and green. Yes, Daniel.
An apple?
Huh. Let's have a look. Oh, it's not. Emily.
A pea.
Show me pea. Top answer, pass or play. that time, Rob, everybody's in agreeance.
It's within the strategy, right?
Yeah. Name something that's small and green.
I'm going to say frog.
Show me frog on the board. Sometimes it just pays to have no strategy, do you think?
No. Well, it hasn't worked for me. I haven't got one yet, I don't think.
Look, it has been noted, team captain. Name something that's small and green.
A plant.
Let's see if it's on the board. Yeah! Yeah. Two to go. Go, Maris. Name something that's small and green.
Kermit the Frog.
Kermit the Frog is small and green. First strike. Emily.
I think a grape. Did we already say grape?
No.
Okay, good.
Would you like to have a shot?
Yeah, I'd like to lock in grape.
Hey, let's do it.
Thank you.
Let's lock it in. Two strikes. Buccheri's good steal. Rob.
Brussels sprout.
Ew. Brussels sprout? Yes.
Chris, to me.
He's just stolen yours, hasn't he?
No, I wasn't thinking of Brussels sprout. I was just mind blanking, actually.
Oh, really? Name something that's small and green.
Alfalfa sprouts, perhaps.
That's specific. Let's check it out. That's the third strike for the Murray family. Buccheri is Adrian.
Kiwi fruit.
Kiwi fruit. Daniel.
It's going to go with the food. Go broccoli.
Mm, nice. Emily.
I think leprechaun.
That's kind of outside the box, and I kind of like it. Sarah.
I hope it's not too far outside the box, because I do like it.
Well, would you be game to go with your own after the last attempt?
No. I'm going to say leprechaun.
Leprechaun for the steal. You're already in front. This will advance you in the competition. Is leprechaun number four? No, it's not. The Murrays get a reprieve. They jump to 227. The remaining answer was... Daniel, 227 to 72. So the newbies have it over the carryover champs. Look, did you know that you can play the game at home as well? Well, you can with our official Family Feud game. It's loads of fun. Just head to 10 play and all the details you need are right there to play. After the break, our families are playing for triple points. Let's see what happens when we come back. Now, the carryover champs are on 72. The Murray family are on 227. A nice strong lead and confident play over here. But the family who gets to 300 points is going to win this one. So we're playing for triple points right now. Adrian and Rob, let's play the feud. We surveyed 100 people and the top 8 answers are on the board. Name something about you that could be fake. Adrian.
Hair.
Your fake hair. Ooh, close to the top. Rob.
I'm going to go laugh.
Show me laugh on the board.
Oh.
Fast or play, mate?
Play.
You feeling this is a little bit do or die right now for you guys?
Yeah, a bit. We're having fun.
Name something about you that could be fake, Sarah.
Your name?
Your name? Your fake name?
Well, I answer to both, so...
Oh, okay, cool. Nice. Or if you're running from the police, you might have a fake name too. What about name on the board? No, not the start you needed, though, but only one strike, Emily. Name something about you that could be fake.
Your teeth?
Your teeth could be fake. The correct one is a confidence builder, isn't it? Righto, Dan.
I'm going to stay on the cosmetic side of things and go fake nose.
Fake nose? Fake? Like a prosthetic nose?
You know, like a nose job kind
of. Oh, okay. Fake nose. Two strikes down, Buccheri's. You currently trail. You need this win, Adrian. Name something about you that could be fake.
Tan? Fake tan?
It's in the word. Love it. Oh, you guys cannot buy a win today.
Thanks.
Murray's, righto.
Oh, Rob's excited, he's clapping his hands.
I'm going to have to say it.
What?
Fake boobs.
I'm going to say a prosthetic limb, like a fake limb.
Fake limb?
Yeah.
Nice.
Eyelashes.
Oh. Oh, Ben.
Ben, what do you have to say why I'm wearing them?
Is that what you meant?
No. Are they naturally that long? They are enormous.
Absolutely.
I should never ask a girl that question, no, should I?
Absolutely.
Christine, what's your answer?
Well, mine are real, yes. Yeah. But boobs.
Oh! I'm glad you clarified that. What is going on here?
Yep.
For the win.
Thank God.
Who would have thought it would come down to...
Oops.
It's goodbye. Round of applause. Emily, lovely. Daniel.
Cheers, mate.
Adrian. Man, we had some fun with you guys. Yeah. Did you enjoy it, Sam?
Yeah, it was great.
It was a little scary that last few games, wasn't it? It was intense. It's like there's so much at stake.
Yeah,
you won't be going away empty-handed. You played magnificently. It was a real joy to have you guys on board. But you'll be getting a gift card for $1,000 from Webjet, Australia's largest online travel agency, which is a great place to compare and book the latest domestic and international flights. Round of applause once again for the Buccheris. Good on you guys. Fast Money, Murray's, who's playing?
That was an intense couple of games.
I revealed a bit too much about myself, I think.
You revealed way too much about yourself.
But that's okay, that's what this show's all about, really. We want to get to know you,
we
want to get to love you. We want you to win money. Do you want to win money?
I want to win money.
Well, head back that way. $10,000, just a couple of questions, just a few seconds. We'll do it next. Fast Money, don't go anywhere in Family Feud.
Congratulations.
Family Feud is on Facebook and Twitter. Plus, you can find us on YouTube and catch all the action on 10Play.
Welcome back for the Fast Money Round. We're here with Christine, Queen of the Overshare. we know so much about one another right now. One thing we do know, that if you and Emily get 200 points or more between you, you'll win $10,000 on your first try. That'd be epic. Now, Emily's currently in our soundproof booth, popping away. I'm going to ask you five questions. It's going to give you 20 seconds to answer. Now, if you pass, we'll come back if there's time, and the clock starts at the end of the very first question. So, you ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck.
Thank you.
Tell me a physical characteristic of a Queenslander.
10.
Name something you hide from children.
Christmas presents.
Name something you associate with marshmallows.
Cooking them.
Name something left lying around in a slob's bedroom.
Socks.
Name something that fluctuates in price.
Houses.
Okay. Ooh. Great job. I think that was fantastic. You ready to see?
Thank you, yeah.
Let's go. Right, here we go. Tell me a physical characteristic of a Queenslander. You said tanned. The survey says... So you're quite clearly aware that that's quite a good start, yeah?
Fair to say? Yeah, sorry about your ear.
Yeah. Oh, I'm bleeding. Name something you hide from children, you said. Christmas presents, the survey says. Oh. Nice. Name something you associate with marshmallows, you said. Cooking them, the survey says.
Oh. Oh.
Name something left lying around in a slob's bedroom. You said... socks. The survey says...
Oh!
I could have sworn that would have been much higher. Name something that fluctuates in price. You said... houses. The survey says... 11. OK. Great start, and it kind of takes off a bit, Christine. But not impossible. Head back to the family through the board. In those shoes?
No.
That's okay. Yeah. I wish I had a pair myself.
You can borrow mine.
You need 124 to get $10,000, okay?
Okay.
So, look, it's a little bit of work to do.
Yeah.
Certainly not out of the realm of possibility, all right?
Okay.
I'm going to ask you the same five questions. I'm going to give you an extra 5 seconds to do so, though, if that's okay.
Okay.
If you give me the same answer as Christine, you'll hear this sound. and I'll ask you to try again.
Okay.
And if you say pass, we'll come back if there's time.
All right.
Can we remind everybody of Christine's answers, please? And 25 seconds on the clock too. And the time starts from the end of the first question. Good luck.
Okay, thanks.
Tell me a physical characteristic of a Queenslander.
A tan.
Try again.
A singlet.
Name something you hide from children.
Pass.
Name something you associate with marshmallows.
Toasted fires.
Name something left lying around in a slob's bedroom.
Clothes.
Name something that fluctuates in price.
The dollar.
Name something you hide from children.
Knives.
Good. Great try, let's go. Confident?
Yeah, very.
Cool.
Maybe.
Tell me a physical characteristic of a Queenslander. You said... singlet.
Yeah.
Survey says... Tanned was the top answer. That's where Christine fired off beautifully. 124 for $10,000. Name something you hide from children. You said... knives? Which is a good point. Survey says... Lollies was the top answer.
Okay.
Name something you associate with marshmallows. You said... toasted. That was the first thing that came out of your mouth, so we have to take your first answer. The survey says... 11. But you know what? Fire was the top answer. We had to take toasted.
Yeah.
Name something left lying around in a slob's bedroom. You said... clothes. I like this answer because it's the top answer.
Yay! I got one, right?
It's nice to see you smile. 70 left now from this last answer for $10,000. Name something that fluctuates in price. You said... the dollar does.
Good answer.
70 or more?
Yes, totally.
The survey says... shot at $10,000. Thanks for watching. Join us again tomorrow night. We'll be on...
Family Feud. Stay tuned out for the project. It's news for all the family. I'm a very relaxed Grant Denyer. Good night, Australia.